Hello, people. This is a continuation of Vampyr. Please enjoy.
So, time to visit the Ascalon Club. It's locked, all right.
Stop!
It's locked. That was the vampire I saw earlier. This war takes no prisoners. It's locked, all right. Locked.
The West End. Never have I felt so sad to be.
Ah! The Ascalon Club. The heart of British Vampire Society. Not quite as subtle as I expected.
Do you know where you are standing right now?
In front of the Ascalon Club, I presume.
The Ascalon Club only summons or ostracizes. What is your business tonight?
I received an invitation. I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed.
Welcome to the Ascalon Club, then, Dr. Reed. Please proceed. Lord Redgrave is waiting on you upstairs.
There has been quite a battle here. I'm sure the Ascalon Club has the money to replace the furniture.
Good evening.
My good friends, if I may have your attention. Behold our visitor, the good Dr. Reed. Newborn of blood so pure and strong that even my friend Fergal Bansher was no match for him.
Hear, hear, hear!
Come forward, young Ekon, for we have so much to discuss. Welcome to the Ascalon Club, Dr. Reed. I am Lord Redgrave, Earl of Bristol and chairman of this exclusive association.
Lord Redgrave.
At last we meet. I've been eager to make your acquaintance. I've heard some astounding things about you. Please accept my condolences for your loss, Dr. Reed.
Thank you, my lord. Lady Ashbury expressed your wish to meet me.
Yes. The lady has always been a useful acquaintance, though not always reliable. Is she a good friend of yours?
She has proved to be helpful on many occasions.
The centuries have taught me never to trust a woman completely, especially if she is immortal. Too prone to emotions, if you ask me. Too fickle when it comes to important decisions.
My lord, do not expect me to speak ill of Lady Ashbury.
Of course not, and I praise your loyalty. Would you offer the same fidelity to the Empire?
What do you mean?
I speak of this Scowl Plague that threatens London and the country. You have been on the front line in the East End, but the time has come to open up a second front here.
The epidemic has escaped the quarantine. You have new cases of the outbreak.
We don't know for certain, but we cannot allow the disease to threaten the prominent heads of Great Britain.
Why have you asked me here?
Because the crisis is escalating. Our enemies, the Guard of Priwen, have even launched an open hunt. The only way to calm things down is to put an end to the epidemic.
You want me to find possible sources of the outbreak in the West End? Is that it?
Ah, straight to the point, like all eager newborns. We shall have time to talk about all this, Dr. Reed, but first, I should like to get to know you better.
Talk? Is that the only reason you asked me here?
Well, no. I also wanted to meet the intriguing Ekon, who made such a powerful progeny of his sister. You have not learned the name of your maker, am I correct?
No, I haven't.
Have no embarrassment, Dr. Reed. We all make mistakes. But whatever your lineage, you are definitely Ascalon material.
What do you mean?
I would like you to become a member of the Ascalon Club, and to serve me as such.
I agree to join the club.
This is good news. Good news indeed in these crucial times. Let's inform the assembly formally and proceed with your initiation.
My initiation?
Fear not. Nothing fancy nor dangerous. It is just that we, the members of Ascalon, believe that tradition and custom are the backbone of this country. My fellow members, dear friends, please gather and welcome this Ekon as one of our own.
Is he worthy? Is his blood pure?
Well, speak, Dr. Reed, in front of the most sacred blood. The blood of our beloved William Marshall, speak now. Will you serve and protect the crown as he did?
Yes, I will.
Then, young Ekon, it is time to testify with your blood. It is time to sign the Book of Allegiance. I know it's awfully gothic and a tad pedantic, but England's traditions are the backbone of our nation. Welcome to the Ascalon Club, Dr. Reed. Take your place among the bearers of the lance.
One of us! One of us!
Good evening, Dr. Reed. How does it feel to be this evening's centerpiece, figuratively?
It's quite unsettling. As a doctor, I am more used to being the observer than the subject observed.
Do not be alarmed. The Ascalon Club has a tried and tested policy for choosing its initiates.
May I ask who you are, sir?
Why would you be interested?
Well, as you seem to be the only man in the room with a beating heart, you draw quite a bit of attention yourself.
Ah, vampire senses never cease to fascinate me. They dwarf those of mere mortals. I am Aloysius Dawson, by the way.
Mr. Dawson, of Dawson and Dawson, the wealthiest man in England. It is a pleasure to meet such a prominent figure of London.
A withering London figurehead, to be precise.
Are you sick, Mr. Dawson? I am a doctor, you know.
My case is beyond the scope of traditional medicine. I have spent fortunes on the world's most competent doctors to arrive at that diagnostic conclusion.
I'm sorry to hear that, sir. Should I suppose that you're here in search of some form of immortality?
Absolutely not. I'm here to implement my plan to save the city I was born in. To cast out the ghastly evil that has us all on our knees.
Money cannot solve every problem. This mysterious epidemic is going to require more than money can buy.
You're right. Money is nothing unless one has the will to wield it. I have a plan, sir. A radical one that will save all that is essential in London.
What is your plan, then?
Quarantine and barricades are futile. What we need is a wall. A formidable, unscalable wall. To isolate the deserving from the infected masses.
Complete isolation has proven effective throughout history, but the death toll has always been a high one.
I am glad you understand the concept of necessary sacrifice.
Are you not mistaking sacrifice for summary execution?
Why do you care? Are you not a vampire, removed from all mortal concerns? Decisiveness is what the city needs, and it needs it now.
That went well, did it not? It is always useful to bolster the troops' morale, especially before a difficult battle.
You have the makings of a general, my lord.
I was, though very long ago. Well, not quite a general, but a proud defender of the crown.
So why did you really want to meet me?
Straight to the point again, young Ekon. All right, let's talk, you and I, Lance Sparrow.
I'm listening, my lord.
According to my spies, you have worked with Dr. Edgar Swansea on the epidemic, and your findings were quite alarming.
Yes, I'm convinced the recent invasion of frenzied Skulls in London is directly linked to the epidemic. This is not the Spanish flu, but something else.
I would be glad to hear more of your discoveries, Dr. Reed, but for now, my main concern is the security of London's inhabitants, both mortal and immortal.
What do you mean?
Alarmed by the epidemic, the Guard of Priwen has started a war against us British vampires. To appease the situation, we must eradicate the Skulls.
Skulls are malevolent and disgusting creatures.
I knew I was right to induct you, Dr. Reed. You would not dare lie to me on such a vital topic now, would you?
So, what do you want me to do?
I want you to investigate the city thoroughly. I have reason to fear there are cases of contagion in this part of town. Our absolute priority is to find and cleanse them.
And how would you like me to proceed?
By all means necessary, Dr. Reed. You are now a member of the Ascalon Club, and you have carte blanche. Interrogate the locals, follow all the leads you find, and get results.
I know we're facing a crisis, but I'm shocked no one took the time to clean up the mess inside the club since we were attacked.
I must admit the Guard of Priwen impressed me. They must have spent years preparing their plan.
How's your investigation going, Dr. Reed? Time is our enemy.
I have a few questions for your lordship.
All right, but be quick.
You made me swear on the blood of William Marshall during my initiation ceremony. Why was that?
William Marshall was the most glorious knight who ever lived. He served five kings and was a living example of probity for all. And he was my maker.
William Marshall was a vampire. Is this some sort of joke? Wait. Could he be my maker?
That would be joyful news. For it would mean he still walks among us. But alas, the great knight has left this world for good.
Why is his blood so sacred to the Ascalon Club?
He was simply the greatest defender of the realm we have ever known. I fought by his side at the Battle of Preston, and he made me his progeny following the fight.
May I ask you about the mortal who attended my initiation, Mr. Aloysius Dawson?
A member of the club does not normally ask questions about other members. We trust each other mutually.
So he really is a member, then?
Indeed. Only the most eminent members are allowed to attend such ceremonies. Even if I admit some of us fled during the first hours of the Great Hunt.
What can you tell me about the Great Hunt?
It's a major concern, and I'm convinced we'll only get a satisfactory conclusion by putting an end to the epidemic.
Goodbye, Lord Redgrave.
Godspeed, Dr. Reed. We are counting on you.
Welcome to the Ascalon Club, then, Dr. Reed.
I think Lord Redgrave just suggested I was sired by an ancient vampire.
Equality between men and women! Women die too in the...
Good evening, miss.
Oh my god, no. Please, Mr. Vampire, don't kill me. Please, no. I'm too young to die. I still have so much to offer this world.
Wait, no. Why do you think I would... What?
Don't worry, Dr. Reed. I know you wouldn't harm me. Mother told me you were in this part of town and might drop by.
Your mother?
My name is Charlotte, sir. Charlotte Ashbury. My mother taught me long ago how to recognize the signs that betray a vampire.
I understand she also taught you how to tease and gently mock innocent young Ekons. It's a pleasure to meet you, Miss Charlotte. I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Have you noticed anything unusual recently?
A few days ago, I spotted a strange house while campaigning for women's suffrage. Awful smell. No answer when I knocked.
Where is it?
It's the Mullaneys, a nice family who live in a big house near the park in the eastern part of this neighborhood.
Goodbye, Charlotte. Give my best regards to your mother when you see her.
She's been quite busy these last few nights. I
suspect you may see her before me.
Welcome to the Ascalon Club, then, Dr. Reed.
Yes, Lancebearer.
Goodbye, Lord Redgrave.
Godspeed, Dr. Reed. We are counting on you.
It's locked, all right.
Lord Redgrave complained.
I cannot enter.
Thank you.
Why are vampire hunters sniffing around here? I need to find out what they're after.
Ah! my vermin!
This woman's body has multiple lacerations. They're deep, too. Whoever did this was driven by rage. This one's neck is broken. He was young. Probably the son.
Your family.
They mocked my talent!
Spare!
seems such a radical mutation. Could it be a new stage in the disease's evolution? So, this girl took lessons at the famous Doris Fletcher acting school. Good evening, Miss Ashbury.
And good evening to you, Dr. Reed.
Goodbye, Charlotte. Give my best regards to your mother when you see her.
She's been quite busy these last few nights. I suspect you may see her before me.
Good evening, sir. May I have your attention, please?
Come on, Johnny. Don't you recognize your oldest friend?
Clarence. Clarence Crossley. How are you? My God. So you survived the war too. So sorry I didn't recognize you at first.
I almost didn't recognize you either. War does that to men, I heard. In my case, it was true, for I witnessed the horror that lies underneath.
I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Can you help me?
Infection is everywhere these days. But if you ever go to the park near that swanky house belonging to the Mullaneys...
Yes? What about the Mullaneys? What about their house?
Not enough noise for a big family with children. Not enough movement. Closed doors. What is going on in there?
You need some rest, Clarence. You should try to sleep.
We shall chase these intruders down.
I was chased by a gigantic Vulcan two nights ago.
Yes, Lance Barrow.
I thought it was Fergal. No. You barely spoke English.
What can you tell me about the Great Hunt?
It's a major concern. and I'm convinced we'll only get a satisfactory conclusion by putting an end to the epidemic.
What about the risk of a full-scale attack here? Jeffrey McCullum is a daring leader.
That is exactly why so many of our number have left the country until things improve. But not me. I founded this club. I'll die defending it.
I have already met Jeffrey McCullum. I am certain he will persist until he has killed every last vampire.
The Guard's current successful recruitment campaign is driven by the ravenous behavior of the Skulls.
I see. So without the epidemic creating Skulls, the Guard could not convince anybody of our presence.
Exactly. Once we have put the epidemic behind us, we need only wait until the Guard grows old and weak. Time will once again become our ally.
May I ask you about the mortal who attended my initiation? Mr. Aloysius Dawson.
A member of the club does not normally ask questions about other members. We trust each other mutually.
But Mr. Dawson is mortal. Are you not afraid he might reveal who you are? Especially to your enemies.
Aloysius Dawson is a man of his word, as are all of us. This is the Ascalon Club, Dr. Reed. We do not grant access to the unworthy.
Goodbye, Lord Redgrave.
Godspeed, Dr. Reed. We are counting on you.
I'm sure you have more important things to do than talking with an old man like myself.
Good evening, old chap. Are you all right?
I won't lie to you, Johnny. I'm not a well man.
When did you escape the war and return to London?
You know what's funny? I almost never think about the war. Not anymore. I'm involved in another kind of battle now.
What is this new battle?
Well, I saw terrible things during the war. Horrors I thought I'd forget. They're here too. They're everywhere. Vampires.
I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Can you help me?
Infection is everywhere these days. But if you ever go to the park near that swanky house belonging to the Mulaneys...
Yes? What about the Mulaneys? What about their house?
Not enough noise for a big family with children. Not enough movement. Closed doors. What is going on in there? I wonder.
You need some rest, Clarence. You should try to sleep. Good evening, miss. Can I help you? I'm a doctor. Dr. Jonathan Reed.
I am... Karina Billow. I don't need any doctor. The rats. Where are the rats?
Miss, you don't seem well at all. Are you afraid of rats? Has one bitten you?
No. It's me who bites them. Tasty, juicy... rats! I can't stop eating them! Help me, please! Help me to disobey the voice!
I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Have you noticed anything unusual recently?
Infection. Infection. The rats carry it, I heard. Rats. 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 Many rats around that big house. Funny smell, too. Dead flesh.
And where is this house?
West of the park. Not very far. A big house with no sound, no light, no life left.
I must go now. Goodbye, Miss Billow.
Rats. Those clever rodents are cautious now. They won't approach.
I must go now. Goodbye, Miss Billow. He had his tongue removed and his eyes gouged out. He was a victim of brutal torture.
Mario deserves.
You Londoners! Gotcha!
It's locked, all right.
Thank you.
Good evening, sir. Please forgive me for disturbing you. I'm a doctor.
I never judge a man by his title, but by his attitude. And you are not disturbing me at all. I am Calhoun Russell, and I welcome you.
Well, I must admit, it's good to receive a warm welcome for once. I'm Jonathan Reed.
Welcome, Dr. Reed. Welcome to my humble shop.
I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Have you noticed anything unusual?
Not really. Wait, now that you mention it, I don't see the McPhersons in my favorite restaurants. They love delicate meals too, you understand?
Thank you. It may be nothing, but I'll investigate anyway. Where do they live?
They have a house in the southern part of the district, somewhere north of the railway bridge. There is a courtyard, if I remember rightly.
Goodbye, Mr. Russell. I'm sure you'll take care of yourself. That building is under quarantine. Could this be what I'm looking for?
Where shall I eat tonight?
It's locked.
This is not a place. Over there! There's one in that curve!
It's locked, all right.
I cannot enter. It's locked, all right. It's locked.
Brought this one up.
cheat, you bastard!
No!
So the husband had an affair with Doris Fletcher. Doris Fletcher seems to be the missing link here. It can't just be a coincidence. I should go to her acting school. It's locked, all right. I cannot enter.
It's locked. It's locked, all right.
Best turn around if I were you.
Easy, Dodge, boys. We can deal with that one.
Sorry, sir. No admittance.
It's locked.
to you! Die, beast!
It's one of them!
Steady, boys! We've got one of them.
There's an open window on the second floor. I should be able to get in through that.
To you, nations of hypocrites. For in front of you stands the tall queen. You
can that be Doris Fletcher's voice? Where does it come from?
Raised through hate, but I offer only love. Woe to you.
I cannot enter.
You who dared enter my realm, are you here to worship or mock me?
I'm here to put an end to the vampire epidemic, Miss Fletcher.
Ah, but Doris Fletcher is no more. She was consumed by this putrid flesh that now enshrouds her.
You feel anger for what happened to you, but I can help you. I'm a doctor, Miss Fletcher.
Doris Fletcher is no more. All that remains are the dreams of the queen she was and the queen she'll be. Until then, all shall die, for that was her final wish. My blade, my children. My beloved, Doc!
sorry, this video has gone on long enough. Please like, share, and subscribe.